was a music teacher was supposed to release have a theatrical release, but then what about this film made you decide that it should release on Netflix?
Okay. So Music Teacher was not, so when we make a movie, we are not trying to figure out whether it'll have a theatrical release or an OTT release. Our philosophy really is, let's make the movie,
right?
Let's give the movie everything that the movie demands within certain parameters, so we're not spending excessively on anything. I think our team over 15 films has learned what is excessive spending and what is correct spending for the story. Once the movie is made, we show it to various partners, some of whom are theatrical distributors, some of whom are OTT platforms, some of whom are traditional cable and satellite platforms, and we try and gauge the kind of response we're getting and then decide you know, where the movie should go. In the case of Music Teacher, just like in the case of Brijmohan Amar Rahe, we figured, which was also a previous Netflix original, we figured that this is the best platform, this is where we'll maximize the reach, this is where we'll maximize the recovery from the movie, and then we took the decision. We had another movie which is released on Netflix called Ashcharya Chakit, which is a slightly racier film. It's not very philosophical, we had a problem with being able to, we made that film with the intention of taking it to single screen theaters, but again, the same process, make the film, start showing it to people. We were we found it very difficult to get a censor certification for that movie, and Netflix really wanted it. So it very naturally goes there. So I think what's happening with this whole fearless tag also is that if you're fearless about your selection of making films, then you should also be fearless about where and following that, where this film naturally wants to go.
Right.
So if the film is naturally going to an OTT platform, you follow it there and hopefully you'll get the deals to take it to an OTT platform.
Right.
And if it's going theatrical, like Hamid did, we went theatrical. Again, for Hamid, which is a movie about the friendship of a 9-year-old Kashmiri boy and a CRPF Jawan, with the Pulwama attacks, with, you know, a lot of attention already in any case being paid to Kashmir and the issue there and all the troubles that Kashmiri people are going through, we felt it's naturally, it needs to get, like, you know, a theatrical release so critics can talk about it, so that when we finally, that film is going to come on Netflix, when we finally put it on an OTT platform, it's already got a little bit of talkability about it.
Right. Also, you said that you had a goal before starting Yugli, you had a goal that you know, you want to make 100 films over 5 years, and you already made 15 films, as you said.
That's a small achievement compared to what we want to do.
Yeah. So, but with the kind of releases you did, your goal changed?
No, our goal hasn't changed. I'll tell you where it's changed. Whenever you start something, you know what they say: aim for the stars, and you'll hit the moon.
Yeah.
So making a big statement like we can make 20 films a year is not something we achieved in the first year and a half of our operations. It's not something we've achieved yet either. But it's our goal. We would like to make that much cinema. We believe there's that much talent in our country and there's that much demand from people for this kind of cinema.
Right?
So the goal has changed to the sense that we now feel that making 12 to 15 films a year is realistic. Maybe a year from now or 2 years from now, if you and I are talking, I'll tell you, listen, we went out and made 20 films.
Right.
Quality control is the most important factor. And with quality, I'd also say budgetary control and making sure that the film is made at the right budget is also a very important factor. So using these two things, as we get better at what we're doing, we'll be able to make more and better films. But I don't think the goal has changed specifically. It's just that we realize that the goal is still a little ahead of us.
Right. And finally, can you shed some light on what future projects you are getting into?
Yeah, I'd love to. We have some very interesting films coming up. We have a film called Nobleman.
Okay.
Which is a film set in a boarding school, you know, in Missouri. It's one of those elite boarding schools that, you know, rich people send their children to. And the film is about bullying in that boarding school.
Right.
And it's got a very deep theme. It's about how monsters are created. And we say that monsters, no person is born a monster.
Right.
Okay, they are created by their circumstances.
Absolutely.
So we show an innocent young 16-year-old boy who gets bullied to such an extent that he himself becomes a monster and a bully. It's a very dark film. We're doing a small theatrical release for this film in May. Right after that, we have two very light films.
Okay.
And they're both in regional languages. So it's a very interesting 3-4 months for us, because we'll first do Nobleman, which is an English language film, which is also very unique. See, we're talking in English in this meeting, in this interview, but a lot of our films are in Hindi. And English is considered, ye kaun si bhasha hai? You know, like even though we're talking. So that's it's almost like we've treated English like a regional language there.
True.
Our next film is a Tamil film called KD.
Okay.
And it's a story of a unique friendship and adventure between an 80-year-old guy and an 80-year-old kid who become best friends, and then they go on this sort of adventure. So again, very interesting, but again, very different to Nobleman. It's not dark. It's got lots of humor. It's got lots of music. It's actually also very emotional, because it's the story of the bond between these two people who both, within the story, been rejected by their families.
Okay.
The orphan was abandoned when he was a child, and the old man, his family, his younger children are wishing that he would die so they can inherit the property.
Okay.
So he's run away from home because of this.
Right.
Right. So it starts with tragedy, it goes into humor, and then it becomes very emotional.
Okay.
So we're doing a theatrical release for that. Right after that, we have a film I'm personally very excited about. It's a Marathi film called Habaddi.
Habaddi.
Which is, it's set in a village. It's Habaddi because the main character is a, you know, Tutla ke bolta hai.
Okay.
So he can't say Kabaddi.
Okay.
So he says Habaddi. But it's a sports film about a 12-year-old kid who becomes a Kabaddi champion.
Right.
And how he does it and why he does it. And, you know, Kabaddi is a pretty big thing in Maharashtra, especially in rural Maharashtra. So again, very exciting and interesting children's film, you know, like, so again, very rare, because it's strange, in India we don't make a lot of children's films, you know. In the business, when you're thinking of business, you always think, if you convince a child to watch your film, you'll sell at least 2 or 3 more tickets along with the child, because maa-baap bhi aayenge picture dekhne, agar bhai bahan hai to wo bhi aayenge picture dekhne. Yet in India we make very few films which are targeted to children. Hamid, which we made, is a film about a child, but it's talking to adults, because the themes in Hamid are a little complex. The themes basically are that if you learn enough about your enemy, then that person won't be your enemy anymore, because you'll start to understand where they're coming from.
Right.
It's not a nothing for a child, you know. It's told through the perspective of a child.
Right.
But Habaddi is a pure child's film. I mean, you know, he jumps into a well to rescue a toy. And inside the well, there's this fantastic world of fishes, and, you know, which you won't find in a well. And there's also a statue of a, you know, little ghost-like figure which scares him. So we've actually made like a fun children's film.
Correct.
With great music and sports. My children, who have never heard of Kabaddi, when they saw the trailer of that movie, they said, can you teach us the rules of Kabaddi?
Right.
So I think it's again very interesting to see urban Bombay kids, you know, saying, "Are ye kabaddi kya hota hai?
Films,
I want to play this game. It looks like fun."
Right.
So I have good hopes in the next couple of months.
Right. All the best for that.
Thank you very
much.
And
thank you so much, Mr. Kumar.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.